He began overthrowing their tables and clearing the temple, saying, "The scriptures declare, my temple will be a house of prayer, but you have turned it into a den of thieves."
The Gospels do not say what Jesus did on Wednesday of Holy Week. Scholars speculate that after two exhausting days in Jerusalem, Jesus and his disciples spent this day resting in Bethany in anticipation of the Passover.
But the Gospels carefully document Jesus' words on love, and those words were supported by action during his ministry and Holy Week.
He healed the sick, raised the dead, and gave a blind man sight.
"I am the vine, you are the branches. If you remain in me and I in you, you will bear much fruit. Apart from me, you send Peter and John ahead to the upper room in Jerusalem to make the preparations for the Passover feast. That evening, after sunset, Jesus washed the feet of his disciples as they prepared to share in the Passover.
By performing this humble act of service, Jesus demonstrated by example how they were to love one another.
Then Jesus shared the feast of Passover with his disciples, saying, "I've been eager to eat this Passover meal with you before my suffering begins. This bread is my body broken for you, and the wine is my blood poured out for you. Do this in remembrance of me."
It is midnight in the Garden of Gethsemane. Jesus is alone praying fervently.
"Father, if you were willing, take this cup from me. Yet, not my will, but yours be done."
Our Savior, who in that moment was human and yet divine, understood what it is to walk a lonely and painful path. And so he walks our sometimes lonely and painful paths with us.
Thank you.
most difficult day of the week.
The colors turn a deep, turn darkness and crimson red.
According to Scripture, Judas Iscariot, the disciple who had betrayed Jesus, was overcome with remorse and hanged himself early Friday morning.
Meanwhile, before the third hour, Jesus endured the shame of false accusations, condemnations, mockery, beatings, and abandonment.
After multiple unlawful trials, he was sentenced to death by crucifixion, one of the most horrible methods of execution in its day.
Christ was led away and carried his own cross to the place of the skull. There he was mocked and insulted as he nailed him to that cross. And yet, this rose of Sharon found forgiveness in his heart.
Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do.
Then, at about the ninth hour, or 3 o'clock on that Friday, Jesus breathed his last and died.
Thank you.
'Tis finished. The Messiah dies.